All of you welcome in our next period. We have started exercise 3, unit 1. We have completed unit of Laplace transformation, unit 3. Cancellation law for addition. The law is given by if A plus B equal to A plus C, then B equal to C. Cancelling A, here we get the cancellation law. B equal to C. For every ABC belongs to real number R. For every ABC belongs to real number R. Now proof of the theorem. Let the first part, the left hand side, A plus B equal to A plus C. Then we have to prove B equal to C. Consider the left hand side, A plus B equal to A plus C, which is given. Now adding minus A to both sides of this equation, in the left hand side, also in the right hand side. Therefore, minus a plus b equal to minus a plus c. Then by associative property, we associate this minus a and a in one bracket, minus a plus b. Again associate this minus a in one bracket plus c. So it is by associative property. Now we know that minus a plus a 0, here minus a plus a 0, therefore 0 plus b, here 0 plus c. This is seen by existence of negative. Since minus a is the negative of a, we get addition 0, here also addition 0. Now this is equal to b plus c, implies b equal to c by existence of 0. Because if we add 0 to any number, we get the same number. Therefore, we consider the left hand side of this statement. A plus B equal to A plus C, and we get the right hand side B equal to C. Hence, the cancellation law is proved. The next theorem is if A, B, C belongs to R, then there is one and only one X, one and only one number X, such that X plus A equal to B. Then, and this number X is given by X equal to, this number X is given by X equal to B plus minus A. If we take A on the right hand side, we get X equal to B plus minus A. We see the proof of the theorem. Let AB belongs to R, real number. Then to show that, we have to show the two statement. X equal to B plus minus A satisfies X plus A equal to B. And second we prove X plus A equal to B implies X equal to B plus minus A. First ratio, the first result is, we have to show the first, X equal to B plus minus A satisfies this. Therefore, consider this X equal to B plus minus A and show that X plus A equal to B. Now, consider X equal to B plus minus A. Adding A on both sides, in the left hand side, also in the right hand side. Adding A on the both sides, therefore X plus A plus equal to B plus minus A plus A. Then by associative property, we associate this minus A and A in one bracket. Therefore, by associative property. Again, by existence of negative, since A minus A is the negative of A, then addition we get 0. Therefore, B plus 0 by existence of negative. Then if I add 0 on any number, we get the same number. Therefore, 0 plus B, we have B. Since by existence of 0. Therefore, X plus A equal to B. We consider this X equal to B plus minus A. And we get X plus A equal to B. That is this first. We put the first, X equal to B plus minus A satisfies X plus A equal to B. Secondly, we put this second one. X plus A equal to B implies X equal to B plus minus A. We put the second, adding minus A to both sides of one. We add here minus a on both sides, therefore x plus a plus minus a equal to b plus minus a. Again by associative property, we associate this a and minus a in one bracket by associative. Therefore, by negative property, a plus minus a, we get 0. Again by existence of 0, we have x plus 0, x equal to this. therefore we get y take here x plus a equal to b and y arrived at x equal to b plus minus a. Therefore you prove this first and two. First and 1 and 2. Therefore the theorem is proved. Then we prove. Then we take the example. Show that A plus B equal to B implies A equal to 0. That is why say here by cancellation law. Let's prove. Consider the given part A plus B equal to B. Then we add here 0 on the right hand side, 0 plus B, because by addition of 0 we get same number, since 0 plus B equal to B. Then A plus B equal to 0 plus B. Then by cancellation law we can cancel B on both sides. Cancelling B we have A equal to 0. Therefore A equal to 0, since by cancellation law. Then we take the theorem. First we prove A belongs to R implies minus A equal to A. Second, AB belongs to R, it implies minus of A plus B equal to minus A plus minus B. I'll see the proof. First, by definition of negative, we have that A belongs to R. Then, by definition of negative, we have A plus minus A, 0. A plus minus A equal to 0. And equal to, we can write minus A plus A. That is why I say that this is by negative property. Since by negative, we say that negative of minus A is A. That is negative of minus A is A. That is we write in terms of symbol negative of minus A, that is minus of minus A equal to e. Therefore, the first proof, this one is proved. Now, second. We know that for AB belongs to R, therefore we have A plus B belongs to R by addition of real numbers. And also minus A minus B belongs to R, then addition of this also belongs to R. Then minus A plus minus B, which also belongs to R. I consider A plus B plus minus A plus minus B. Now by commutative property, we interchange this minus A plus minus B written as minus B plus minus A. The first term as it is plus this is minus B plus minus B plus minus A. Same by commutative property. Again we take the associative property. We associate this minus B and B. By associative property we associate, therefore equal to A plus B plus minus B plus minus A. Same by associative property. Again by negative property, the addition of this will get 0, therefore A plus 0 by negative property. Therefore A plus 0 plus minus A. Same by existence of negative. Same by existence of negative. Because minus B is the negative of B, therefore addition will get 0. Again, if we add 0 in any number, we get the same number. Therefore, by existence of 0, we get A plus minus A. Since by existence of 0. Again, by negativity property, we get 0. Implying the left hand side is A plus B plus minus A plus minus B equal to, again by negative property, again 0. Since by existence of negative, now from this statement we say that negative of A plus B is this, so that addition will be 0. That is negative of A plus B addition of this is 0, therefore negative of A plus B equal to this second this bracket is minus A plus minus B. Therefore, we say that minus of A plus B equal to minus A plus minus B. Implies minus of A plus B equal to minus A plus minus B. We prove the second. Therefore, to prove the theorem, we prove the first and we prove the second. The theorem is proved completely.